Social media. You need to have every single platform there is. Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube. You name it. Every single platform. You need it. You need it. Working on the weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual. Niggas swear they passed us. Hey y'all, it's your favorite nail queen here, Queen L Nails. Welcome into my channel. If it's your first time, make sure you guys go ahead and subscribe. And if you're coming back, welcome back. I'm about to get into the juice, okay? The straight up juicy juice of the nail game, which is how to build your nail clientele. People ask me all the time, like, how do you get so successful? How do you get so many clients, you know? While I'm in school, getting my license for nails, while I'm at home building my business, unlicensed and while licensed, how to build a clientele. And honestly, the clientele that you have is based off how you are presenting your business, the way you see your business, the way you believe your business to be too. Okay, I don't want to get like super spiritual, but please have faith that you will build clientele and that you will get the clientele that is meant for you. Okay, it's very easy to weed and see out the ones that are going to come in and out as well. But for the most part, most clients stay with you, especially when you are staying focused on like nail health, nail longevity, and educating your clients on their nails and what they're doing and what's best for them.
You got on lips, nail polish?
No, this is no.
That's gel tip.
No. Okay, whoa. Hold on. No. This is I get manicures. I'm clean. I can't.
So why didn't you just say yes when I asked you? Is that nail polish?
It's not. It's
clear nail polish.
No, that's not nail polish.
Gel polish?
That's nail polish?
Yeah.
But it looks nice.
I didn't say it didn't. You just became defensive because you're insecure. Next.
They'll stay, okay? They will stay for a long time. You will always have one-timers that are in and out your chair. You'll always have chair boppers and chair hoppers, but please do not get discouraged by those type of people, okay? Remember that, you know, who's meant for you will come to you, and there's a clientele for everybody. Do not feel like being a nail tech is oversaturated or there's a lot of nail techs, because there's really not, honestly, and especially nail techs of color, there's not a lot of us. There's still room for everybody, no matter who you are, black, white, brown, yellow, sky, blue, don't matter. There's room for you, okay? So how to build your nail clientele. First thing, I have my notes here, so I'll be looking. First thing is footwork, okay? Now, this is game A, like old school, OG way to get your nail clientele. Footwork. Get outside and get walking, okay? If you're at home nail tech or a private nail tech, go around your neighborhood and walk on foot. Get you some business cards. Now, you definitely need business cards. I probably should have started with this, but have business cards, okay? Let me not put all my business out there, but have business cards here, okay? Get a business. This is my business card. I have referrals at the bottom, deposit, my hashtag, this, that. It doesn't matter. You can get business cards from anywhere, okay? And then in the front, you know, it says where I'm at, who I am, where I'm at, where I'm located. These business cards are so basic. They're so simple. They're so easy, but they're mine, right? And
they're gonna go pass out some nail cards.
I have a price list sheet that has my full prices. Says I'm home-based now, home-based studio, all my prices, my policy, my info here, and social media, okay? So I have a pricing sheet and I have a business card. And I started from, this was my first original price sheet, okay? I have my business card picture on top, my nail, some of my nail pictures here, and then my pricing sheet. And this was my first ever, business card. This is my first pricing sheet, and I've upgraded. I upgraded my stuff, okay? And I still want to change my business card again. It don't matter. The point is, have them, okay? And then footwork. Go around your neighborhood. Go around where your salon is, where your shop is, and start handing them out. Hand them out to local businesses. Go to the grocery store. Hand them out to any person you see who does not have their nails done. Even if they do have your nails done, get that client, okay? They may not have been happy with the service that their nail's done, or they maybe they're going to a shop and you're a private nail tech and you want to get that grill that clientele in. Get on foot, okay? Leaving your flyers even on people's cars, like people's car doors, putting them in mailboxes. I have gone to stores like Target, Walmart, again, grocery stores, and TJ Maxx, Marshalls, and I will put my nail card inside of the beauty area. So I'll go to the beauty area, whether it's like, you know, the soap, shampoo, even what's it called, press-on nails. I put them inside the press-on nails box because people who want their nails done, you know, they're going for something a little bit more convenient and cheaper, but who's not to say that they won't come sit in your chair, because they will, okay? The text that you say in the captions, the videos we got ever leak, we going viral or going platinum. Don't worry about your friend's story when I had her alone. She gonna try and put some extras on to take you out of your zone. You know how it goes when they can't get a reservation up in Carbone. They gonna tell you it's a chill night, tell you how they rather stay home. Yeah. Every time I go through a drive-through, any sort of drive-through, you know, anything, I pass it out, Starbucks, you know, fast food, any place I go to, when I pick food up, I give it to them. DoorDashing, I give it to people when I DoorDash my food. I used to even work DoorDash. When I was working DoorDash, I was putting my business card in with people's food. I'm like, I'm supposed to be all right. But I was putting my card in with people's, like, orders when I was DoorDashing, and trust me, I got so many people. I got a few people who booked, but I also, that helped me build my social media. People would just follow me on social media, and I still know to this day those people will come back to me, okay? So get on foot, hand those people, hand out to people in person, network with these people, introduce yourself, tell them who you are, what you're doing, what you're servicing, what your niche is, if your niche is, or just say, hey, you know, I'm right around the corner, you can book with me here. Boo, boo, boo. Building, that's the low grade number one thing you can do, which is old school. Get on foot, get outside, introduce yourself to people, and get your clients in your chair, okay? Number two would be, I kind of just covered what would be business, though. Business cards, flyers, stickers. I just showed you a couple, but you must invest into some business cards. Even if it's just a business card, you're going to have both like I do, the price sheet and the business card, but you just need something with your name, your business name, and how to contact you, or and how to maybe get to your social media. That's it. Like, you just need them to be able to contact you and be able to see your work, because they're not just going to know who you are, what you were, you know. You need to be a representation of what you are. Have your nails done. Mine aren't on right now because, like I said, I'm in school and I'm doing a lot of videos and stuff, so mine are on and off. But keep your nails done, okay? You are your business. You are your walking project, right? And what's it called? Have a platform where they can go to get. So social media, okay? Have your social media linked to your business card. So, okay, get your business cards or get a pricing sheet as well. Have your flyers. It's very important to have a pricing sheet too. If you want a video about that, just comment below about how to set your prices. Okay, I'll do a separate video. But just, you need something to give people to remember, to hold on to. You know, you give them your business card, boom. They're going to put this right in their wallet. They're going to put it right in the front of their car when they see it all the time. Or they're going to go on social media and they're going to follow you right away, see your work, start liking your work, see what your area is, see what your room looks like. Like, this is my space. See what your room looks like, you know. And they're going to be super interested in who you are, what you're doing, okay? Give them something to look forward to. But also, when you're handing this to them, you know, this is your first impression is everything. So make them feel warm, make them feel happy. Tell them why they should choose you as your nail tech. What is it that you do different than their current nail tech or their current shop, you know? So I'm luxury, okay? I'm an at-home based nail tech, okay? That's luxury to me. I don't care. Coming into somebody's house or somebody coming to your house to do your nails is a luxury service. Going into the shops, that's one thing, but having that personal one-on-one individual relationship with people is just top tier, okay? It's way different. Number three, word of mouth. How to get your clientele, word of mouth, okay? Once you do some bomb nails, okay? Once you do some bomb nails, I'm buying my fair nails. Next thing you know, they're gonna tell their sister, they're gonna tell their brother gonna tell their girlfriends or their wife, they're gonna tell their cousins, they're gonna tell their aunties, they're gonna tell their mama, their grandmamas. You're gonna be servicing the whole family, okay? I'm just letting you know right now, you're gonna be doing everybody's nails. One person equals up to almost 10 people, okay? And those 10 people go to 100 people. Word of mouth. You want to make sure when you do these services that you're doing your best at all times. And even if you feel like your client is not satisfied, you want to at least satisfy them in the moment to get them to come back by offering maybe a discount in the current service. You know, like if only if they're unsatisfied. I don't really believe in giving out discounts like that, but well, that's another story. And, you know, just word of mouth, do a great job, be great at what you do, be pleasant, be nice, have great customer service, okay? Customer service is number one when it comes to building your business. And you want to be nice, you want to be pleasant, even when you don't feel like it. Even if you know, maybe the client is being very hard client, you know, somebody very particular, very strict on what you're doing. Maybe they want you to redo a design like multiple times. That is okay. Be pleasant, be patient. You know, word of mouth is so important. You want to get that person in your chair one time. As soon as they're in their chair one time, they should always return. They should always come back unless they literally are moving or they're sick or, you know, whatever. Life being four would be referrals and punch cards. Now, this is option, but it is a way to get people in your chair, right? So if you service somebody, you can say, hey, if you refer somebody to me, I'll take $10 off your next set, or I'll take a certain percentage off your next set. I don't really believe in giving percentages because sometimes the percentages are way more than the cost of the nails. So I like to do a dollar amount. Like, I'll give you $10 off, I'll give you $20 off if you refer two people to me or a person to me, you know. So referrals is really great because that person, you're gonna do a bomb set of nails on them, right? And then they're gonna tell their best friend or tell their sister, and then their sister's gonna come and get in your chair. That's two for one, okay? Two for one. So the next time that first person comes, they come back after their referral, you know, just give them a nice little discount, 10 bucks, 20 bucks, because that one person you just made $100 off of, you know what I'm saying? Like, they spent their money on you and then they referred somebody else. So you just made double from one person, right? And if they bring you even multiple, it's nothing to give them $10, $20 off their set, or to give them free nail art one time, or give them free gems or something on their nail set for referring somebody to your business. And that is being so graceful and so amazing and helping your business to prosper. Like, you know, you give and then people will pour into you, right? Number five, a great way that I built my business, especially when I first became a nail tech, was I asked for models. So I would say, hey, I'm looking for a nail model, I'm giving out a free set. Or I'll say, hey, I'm looking for a nail model, only $25, whatever you want, right? This was a great way for me to help build my portfolio when I first started doing nails, so that people could see the nails, like what I'm doing. You know, saying, hey, I'm doing nails, but there's nothing on your Instagram, there's nothing for you to show, there's no pictures that you're posting with it, that doesn't help you at all. And I'm about to go into about social media. We're getting there. Hold on. Just hold on a second. If you got this far, go ahead and hit that like button. Okay, it's free. Hit the like button. And make sure you comment below in the comment box something. If you have a question or anything, or if there's another video you want me to like touch on, something I might have talked about and I haven't really said it, go ahead and put in the comments what you want to see. Okay, and subscribe, y'all. Please be subscribed to my channel here. I love to see you guys here. I love to see you guys coming and growing.
Bet you think it's small. We need to be thinking big. You need to be thinking big, bitch.
And so, again, back to models. So, yeah, I would post I'm looking for models, and I would say a free nail set, or I'll say $25 nail set, whatever you want, or $30, whatever you want. Another way that I post it for models, once you find your niche and you really know what kind of services you want to offer as a nail tech, like if you want to specialize in French tip, you want to specialize in gems, you want to specialize in XXL nails, you want to specialize in short, cute, classy nails, or almond shaped nail, or gel X, you know, acrylic, gel, whatever it is you know that you want to specialize in, and you find that niche, what I would do is I would post a picture of nails that I want to do, but I don't have a clientele to do it at the moment. I'll post that picture and I'll make it like in a collage or something. What I'll use is like, I'll use like a thumbnail app or I'll use Canva. Okay, Canva is that good girl. Okay, she's building businesses around here. Okay, Canva. And I would put like a couple pictures together and I would be like, looking for models for this set, $50 only. Looking for models for this set, $35 only. Or if I have the four pictures there, I'm going to put one of that I did on the side over here. I'm going to put it up here, how I put in a little collage. And I would just put the price on each photo. It'll be like $35, $30, something super cheap, super affordable. Now, this is, that would not be how much I would charge for that actual work when somebody comes to me, right? But by the time somebody sees that, that person comes in and says, yeah, I want my nails done, $35. I'll do that one for you as a model. I service that one person for $35, but they're probably a $115 set. Or they're probably like an $85 set. You know what I'm saying? But by the time that person came in, modeled, that picture's already down off of my page. And it brought me the clientele that I wanted. So when you, especially when you really want to specialize in something specific, get some models of some people to come in and do those nail sets for you, so then you will attract that clientele to come to book with you for those specific type of nails, okay? I do believe in, as a nail tech, you should be able to do anything regardless if you like it or not, it's your specialty or not. But, you know, of course we have our niche. We have what we love. We have what we're going to do. But we also have what we don't like, or maybe we feel like we need to practice more. And I won't say we're not good at, but something we need to practice more. Because usually when we don't want to do something as a nail tech, it's because you're not good at it. It's because you ain't practiced enough. It's because you ain't picked that brush up and you ain't got to work on it for like 40 hours practicing it to make it perfected, okay? Real talk here, okay? And then, of course, last but not least, I would say number two and best way to build your clientele is social media. This is the times we live in. This is the amazing time. But even back before social media was like Instagram, you know, TikTok, YouTube, throw it back, MySpace, they had commercials, guys. Okay. Marketing yourself, marketing your business, marketing your nails is the number one top tier way to gain a clientele. Now,
What a money reside.
Social media is number two, because I honestly feel like footwork is number one. Like footwork and word of mouth is kind of like the number one way to grow your clientele. But social media is definitely one or two, right?
You got to get on your Zoom, matey. You got to get on your Zoom at 10.
Marketing is number one. Marketing is way different than social media. Marketing is just you doing any one of these options I've told you and putting it out there. That's marketing. So number one is marketing yourself, marketing your business, right? Social media. You need to have every single platform there is. Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, you name it. Every single platform, you need it. You need to be on there and you need to be posting daily, if not multiple times a day, until somebody has booked you and got into your chair, okay? I can't stress this enough. Like, social media is so big. And I don't honestly, don't give me the excuses. It's too much. It's too much time. I don't know how to do it. I don't know. Girl, bye.
You don't really want it that bad. And most people don't want it that bad.
Log off right now, because if you're already giving up those excuses, you're not ready to be a nail tech and you're not serious about doing this.
Are you serious right now, bro?
Let me tell you, I am constantly posting about my business to the point where people are contacting me and I'm booked, or I'm not available the day they need or the day they want me, and I have to try to figure out how to squeeze them in or move them around, or, you know, like, that is how booked and busy and blessed you will be if you follow these steps that I'm giving you. I promise you.
I am booked. I am busy. I am in demand. I am doing everything according to the plan. I trust myself. Trust the universe. I am putting myself and my dreams first.
It has helped me build clientele over and over. I have moved twice and rebuilt my clientele. I've moved states, I've moved cities, and I have never lacked and having clientele, okay? Because I put myself out there. Social media, number one. So Facebook, okay? Get a Facebook page or just use your personal Facebook and start posting. The best way that worked for me, it works for everybody, but for me was on Facebook. I joined groups. I joined the Facebook beauty groups in my city, in my area around me. So within 5, 10, 15, even 20 miles around you, I would join the beauty groups. I would join the hair groups. I would join the nail tech groups. I would join all these groups. Even Facebook Market, like Marketplace. You could post your picture on there for free and say, hey, I'm a nail tech in your area. My deposit is $20, or just post it as $20 and people start hitting you up, hey, I'm looking for $20 now. And that's when you can say, hey, here's my booking site. Hey, here's my website. Or hey, that's my deposit. What are you looking to get done? You know, or just say, hey, what are you interested in? What are you looking to get done? Send me an inspo picture. Okay, cool. That set costs about, you know, $80, but my deposit's only $20. When would you like to be serviced, right? When are you available? I'm telling you, I got people so fast from Facebook groups posting my work, saying, hey, introducing myself, saying, hey, you guys, it's me, your favorite nail queen, Queen O Nails. I'm located in XYZ. I'm looking for clients. This is what some pictures of what I am. This is my Instagram to look at my pictures. I'm starting at this price, or I'm looking for people right now to fill my chair at $50, whatever you want. Like, boom, market, boom, damn, done. And I would post that every day until I get somebody. Or I would post it. Facebook groups are kind of like, it depends how big the traffic is. Sometimes once a week or like every day, but I would at least post that once a week. And then I gained a lot of clientele. If you have a military base in your area too, like we have a lot of military here. I'm in Washington, so we have a lot of Seattle, Washington, not DC. Okay, get that clear. And we have a lot of military base. So I was kind of like 15, 20 minutes from the military base. So I joined the military base like beauty area, or I would just join military base areas, because a lot of those military men or women, their wives are just chilling at home looking for something to do. Hello, during the day. Hey, I'm a nail tech. Moms groups. Moms. Join the moms. Get the stay-at-home mamas to come get their nails done, okay? Just put your work out there, okay? Promote yourself, promote your business, and don't get tired of it until you're tired of it.
I'm tired of this, Grandpa.
That's too damn bad!
Because you're so booked, you don't even have to post but your work, right? What's next? Instagram. Instagram is big. I think Instagram is probably number one, because everybody asks nowadays, what's your Instagram? Or sometimes I guess TikTok. TikTok's getting a little bit more popular, but Instagram, everyone's like, what's your Instagram? People want to know your Instagram. Like, it's the perfect place to build your portfolio. It's posting pictures, posting videos, posting, you know, now they have like reels and stuff nowadays. So you can post reels, all that of like your setup, your room, what it looks like. You can post about what you do. If there's special things you do while you do nails, like if there's a special way you do your prep, if there's a special thing, like maybe you give a hand massage, or there's something extra that you do that you want to show people, hey, this is the reason why you need to book me. Instagram is perfect for this, okay? Along with TikTok, I really love for like videos and, you know, getting to know me, or telling story time, or showing my application, showing new products that I've purchased that I'm going to be using. People want to know, you know, people are nosy. They want to know. They want to know everything. I'm sorry. Like, and it's either you're posting your business or you're watching somebody else. So what would you prefer to do? Post your business and have clientele in your chair and people coming to you, or watching somebody else get their clientele and get their business?
You're always in my views, but never in my likes.
You choose, okay? You choose. I'm choosing. Girl, come to my chair and I'm going to post to every day. I'm post so much they tired of me posting. They mad, they hating, because I'm popping and I'm posting.
Right now there's somebody talking about you, but I want you to take that as confirmation. If you ain't got no haters, you ain't popping.
And I got clients, and I'm a successful nail tech. You are successful now, tech too. Claim it. It's yours. But this is the work you got to do. It's cute and fancy online. You see all the nail techs, see all the cute. It's work. Okay, it's your job. You said you want to quit your 9-to-5, right? Get to work. Okay. And YouTube. YouTube now is very advanced. Honestly, I don't recommend starting with YouTube. I really recommend Facebook, Instagram, TikTok. They're the easiest, especially just Instagram building up, because that's your portfolio. What you're doing now is people say, oh, let me see what you do. Instagram, boom, got your nail pictures there, blah, blah, blah. YouTube now is a lot harder. YouTube is very advanced. YouTube is technically a full-time job in its own, but it is very profitable, okay? Getting on YouTube and showing like your nails, showing the process of doing your nails. And now YouTube has shorts, and shorts actually grow your YouTube a lot faster than these longer videos kind of ish nowadays. But YouTube is still YouTube University. Okay. You're here. You're still here. You're watching this. This video is pretty long. And thank you for being here with me. Make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more info about being a successful nail tech. But YouTube is like, you can make money, good money off of YouTube. This is my second YouTube channel. This is not my first one. And when I tell you, this is a great way to create a form of passive income and create money while you sleep. Because nails, being a nail tech is very hard. It's very hard on you. It's very hard on your body. It's a lot of work, and you can't do nails while you're asleep. But if you're on here posting videos and posting your work, eventually you will get to a place where you get monetized and you could be creating money because people are watching your videos while you sleep, right? And that's very important, very, very important as a nail tech, right? Last but not least, the final thing that you can do to build your clientele after you done footwork, got your business cards, your pricing sheets, you got your referrals out there, you got all your portfolio, you got your portfolio out there on your Instagram and your Facebook, and everything's all lit, and you know, you're posting everything.
Ooh, this is nice! Girl! This audience is you right here? Okay.
Getting a couple clients, you know, getting a little money, or you're working your 9-to-5, hopefully, or doing whatever it takes to source money to grow your business, right? The final thing, that one of the best ways to build clientele, is ads. ADS, ads, posting ads, or paying for ads, paying for boosting your ads. Your local radio station. That might sound old school, but radio is popping, okay? Radio stations, your local beauty supply stores, DJs, different things like that. Social media, okay?
You just try to kick me in my face? I thought we was teammates.
Boosting your post on Instagram. So, like, if you post, I feel like I want to show this, but like, if you go on Instagram, I might enter, might not, I don't know. But if you go on Instagram or TikTok or Facebook, and like Facebook, you can create a business meta suite, okay? And you can connect that with your Instagram. And so when you post on Instagram, it'll also post on Facebook. So you post one time, which is two times for you. So it makes it easier to make, you know, like all this posting. I know you probably feel like, oh my God, it's so overwhelming. It's a lot. But there is ways and avenues to post once and it posts to two or three other places, okay? Your Instagram can post to your story, your Facebook page, your Facebook story all at once. Same with TikTok, you can connect to post to like your Facebook, your Instagram, all that together. And the same with YouTube, like YouTube can be connected to post to your Facebook. Boosting your post and creating, paying for ads, it can be as low as $5, $10, and you can do this maybe once a week, twice a week, once a month even. But paying for my boosted ads has brought, it doesn't only just bring you clientele, it brings you traffic on your social media, more followers, more views, more likes, more comments. It's one of the best ways to build your social media platform and to build your clientele and to build your business to gain more money. Okay, having that picture posted on Instagram and you boost it to people in your area, you know, within 5 miles, within maybe 10 miles of your area. And people are seeing that on their page. They're going to follow you. They're going to look at your work. They're going to be DMing you to book, or they're going to be clicking your link in your bio to book. And I cannot stress the consistency of this, how much this really works. And it, at the end of the day, it takes money to make money, period. It takes money to make money, okay? And scared money don't make none. So you have to invest into yourself. You have to invest into your business. And once you get to a place where you can afford to pay for ads, please, please, please do it, okay? Especially if you're coming into a slow season, or if you feel like, you know, there's a slot you're trying to fill, you know, please boost and pay for ads. It's like, it works. It works. You invest $5, $10 to get a $100 client in your chair. You know, maybe even you invest $20 and, you know, you boost that post for a couple days or for a week long, and you're getting all these people who are watching you. And the thing with people following you and watching you, don't never give up, or don't never feel like, oh, I got all these followers when nobody's booking. The thing is that people will watch you. People will watch you for a while before they book you. Sometimes they're watching you for a month, 2 months, 6 months, a couple weeks, or maybe they're just watching you for the week to see how much do you posting? How many clients do you got? How serious are you about this? Because, you know, you don't want to just post once a week and then you got them same red nails sitting there for this person to look at, and you ain't posting nothing for 7 days, and it was Monday and they waiting for Friday for payday to book you, or it's Wednesday and they're waiting on payday to book you to pay your deposit or just to book because they can afford it then. And then you ain't posting nothing since them raggedy red nails 2 weeks ago. They're gonna be like, what nails you doing? What else can you do? Just that's it. That's why I cannot stress, like, posting consistently, posting every day, your page, your story, your reels, your Facebook, your TikTok, your Instagram, your YouTube, everything. Post, post, post. Show people that you are serious about this. Show people that you are dedicated to your work and your craft and what you're doing. And they will come support you, okay? Just because they see your nice nails one time, it may not reel or hook them in. But if you keep throwing it in your face, you keep posting every day, you post twice a day, three times a day, you keep posting and posting and posting, they ain't gonna have no choice but to come. One time their nail tech is busy, one time they can't go to the shop and they know you're open late, or they know you're at home nail tech and they can come to you, they're gonna come. They're gonna come running. Running, okay? I've had people hit me up last minute for their weddings. I've had people hit me up right before their vacations. I've had people hit me up, you know, baby showers, all different type of special occasions that happen last minute. And they've seen my work. They know I'm capable, but they just haven't had a chance to come get in my chair, and boom, they come. So don't be discouraged and don't give up if it doesn't happen right away. This isn't instant gratification with nails, okay? This does not happen overnight. It takes time, all right? It takes time. It takes investment. And treat a free nail set client the same way you would treat a celebrity client, okay? Just because maybe they're not paying you, you want to give them a full experience as if they're a celebrity or somebody who's paying your car note with this nail set, or paying your rent with this nail set. Because the money, yes, it matters, but it's your customer service. It's the experience you're giving them. You want word of mouth. You want referrals. You want them to go brag about your name to the top God to the world, because you are creating top tier service. You're creating great customer service for these clients, okay? And that's it, y'all. That's what it takes. Get on foot, get your business cards, pricing sheets, pass them out everywhere you go. You should always, always, always have them. I keep my nail cards in my car. Like, you know, when you close the car door, like, I have a little thing right there where I could store stuff. I keep them right there. I keep them in my car. I keep them in a slouch in my wallet. I always have my business cards on me because I am always passing them out.
We're gonna go pass out some nail cards.
Like a baby girl, wipe them like you snotty for your baby girl.
Take a card. All right, yep, which is good.
For you. Turned on the news and seen that man who never got pussy in school and making noise about women could
Your niggas put hands on you in the past, insecure because your body is pressure. Four words when I think about them is crusty, musty, dusty, rusty. Eight words when I think about us is fuck me, fuck me, fuck me, fuck me. Disrespect, yeah, and I smack them. The text that you say in the captions, the videos we got ever leak, we going viral or going platinum. Don't worry about your friend's story when I had her alone. She gonna try and put some extras on to take you out of your zone. You know how it goes when they can't get a reservation up in Carbone. They gonna tell you it's a chill night. Tell you how they rather stay home. Yeah.
Now, if you got this far, I'm gonna give you a gem. And if you got this gem that I'm about to give you, you're going to please comment below, "You are my favorite nail queen." Or just put a comment below. Put some green hearts below so I know that you made it this far, because the gem I'm about to give you is something that I personally do to get clientele, and it works. Okay, now I specifically made my business card with this gap here, right? You want to know why? I'm gonna show you. Let's see if this pen is really working. I'm gonna show you why. I wish I had a Sharpie. I usually do this with a Sharpie, but it's okay. See if this is, because it's not really writing the way it needs to. There it is. This is ugly writing, but you see what I just wrote? My pen wasn't working. Free full set. Okay. I kept this gap on my nail card on purpose because on my business cards, I will write, like before I go put them in the box of diapers at Target, or I put them in those press on nails, or I put them in hair dye boxes and all types of stuff in there. You know, cosmetic stuff and TJ Maxx and all different places I've stored these cards. I will write a discount on the card. Now, like I said, I don't really do discounts like that. But when I'm placing my business card somewhere where somebody isn't getting a personal interaction with me, or maybe they are, I play this like, you know, like what's it called? Like the lottery. Whatever card I pick out is what it's got. I'll put $10 off a service. I'll put free nail design. I'll put free nail art or charms. I will put $5 off a manicure. I'll put $20 off a full set. That is a lot of money. Off a full set. I keep looking at it. That's a lot of money off a full set. Okay. I will put, you know, and every once in a while, I will gamble and I'll put free full set on a card and I will hand it to somebody and they will be like, "Are you serious? Are you really gonna do free?" And I'm like, "Yes, I will do your nails for you. You got the number one lottery ticket, girl. Get in my chair and get your nails done, okay? You're a lady, you're a woman, you're beautiful. Come enjoy yourself. Get this self-care. Come to me, be empowered, enhance your beauty, and come get some self-love and self-care on yourself and come get your nails done, sis, okay? This is what I'm here for." And that is something that has very much so worked. Very much so worked on gaining clientele and getting clientele in my chair. Okay. So thank you guys so much. If you're here, please make sure y'all hit the subscribe button, hit the like, let me know in the comments which one of these strategies you are going to use next to build your clientele. I really hope this video was resourceful to you. I promise you it has helped and it has worked a lot, so much for me. And creating my business and gaining clientele, like, booked and blessed I am, and you will be too, as becoming a successful nail tech. So this is what it takes to build clientele as a nail technician. And yeah, good luck to y'all. Get out and get your booties up and get out and promote. Get out and get those clients, because it doesn't matter where you are. Somebody did their nail set right now, because I know I do. Because if you came to me, be like, "Sis, let me do your nails." I'm like, "Girl, I'm a nail tech. I do it myself, but baby." Get out there. I love you guys so much. Thank you. It's your favorite nail queen, Queen L Nails. Until next time, bye.
Working on the weekend like usual.